When you initiate your squat, i.e. when you start lowering down, there are two main mistakes that you can make, and if you make them, it's gonna set the rest of your squat up for failure. So I'm gonna tell you what those mistakes are and some simple drills to start fixing them. When you lower down into your squat, basically what we want is for the knees and the hips to bend at the same time. Now, you can argue some of the nuances with this in terms of different styles of squatting, but basically you want the knees and the hips to break, the bum to go slightly back, and for you to just sit straight down in between your legs. Some people will have a more knee dominant, or what some people will call a more quad dominant squat, where the knees shoot forward, the hips don't really go back, and a lot of times this results in people coming up on the toes a little bit. And other people will make a mistake of having a more posterior chain or maybe hamstring dominant squat, what some people would call that, where they sit back really, really far, the knees don't really come forward at all, and it results in this really forward pitch of the torso, which is problematic. If you have the problem of sitting too far back in your squat, this is maybe a little bit less common, but it can be really difficult to fix. So if your squat tends to look like this, what we want is for you to be able to allow those knees to travel a little further forward and sit down a little more upright. So one drill that we've been playing around with that has been really effective for this is sort of like a reverse wall squat. So what you're gonna do is set up to where your bum is just a couple inches away from the wall. You're gonna start by pushing the knees forward and basically trying to squat down, keeping the chest up without allowing your bum to touch, either on the way down or on the way up. Obviously, if you lean back too far, your bum's gonna touch on the way down. And if you come up and you have a little bit of a tip or lean forward, which is a common problem, you're also gonna get that immediate feedback. You can practice that with body weight. You can then add some weight to it in a goblet squat by holding a dumbbell and progress that up to where you can then do more complex variations like back squats, front squats, and so on with that proper form of sitting straight up and down. If you have the problem of your knees initiating the squat more than sitting back with the hips, then a really simple fix to that is basically to set up with a bench or a box behind you, and you want to have a little bit of a gap so you're not right up against the bench, and you're basically just gonna initiate with your bum sitting back so you touch your bum onto the bench and stand back up. The cue that I really like for this, and which you can do if you're a coach, is to almost grab the back of the person's pants right below their bum and basically pull it on about a 45 degree angle right back, right? That's kind of the feeling of pushing the hamstrings back and down toward the floor that you wanna have as you initiate the squat. And again, you can add load to that over time and build that up so you avoid having that knees forward squat and you have something that looks a little better and that functions a little better for you. So that is how you want to fix your squat. I hope you like this video and I'll see you on the next one.